whatever you, whatever you guys are doing, I'm already starting. Hi, guys.
Hello.
Hey, Ryan. Hey, I'm Jason Duplissea. I'm producer on the film Temps. Welcome to our hangout. We're hanging out again tonight. A lot of us crazy cookie hangouters are hanging out together. This is Grant Rosenmeyer. He's in the film Temps. That's Ryan Sage back there. He's the director.
He's over there.
And this is Lindsey Shaw. She's one of our actresses.
Hello.
I'm Lindsey. Film as well.
Hey.
And we'd like to say a special... Okay. I'm going to be a big downer right now and bring everything to crash and halt to say the whole reason we're doing this, first of all, is in support of our film Temps. So if you love us like we love you, then you can head on over to our website, tempsmovie.com, and find out the link to the Kickstarter. So
or you can go to kickstarter.com and search for Temps.
Correct. There. You can also go to kickstarter.com and search for Temps there. Or you can follow us on Twitter at tempsmovie. And you can, what is something else you can do?
Instagram
at tempsmovie. You can follow us on our YouTube channel. But the main thing is to figure out how to get us funded so we can get this fantastic film to you.
You can chant at tempsmovie over and over and over and over and hashtag tempsmovement over and over and over and over with the intention of pushing us forward to our goal.
Yeah, send us your power animal.
We'll please, we just need it for a little bit.
Just for like 15 days.
We should say special happy Spirit Day. We're all in our
happy Spirit Day. Oh, I hope everybody enjoyed such a wonderful day.
So nobody can be mean to us too. That's sort of like no web bowling.
It's a really pretty purple dress.
Okay. I'm wearing tigers on it
very
too.
Soon we're going to have Reed Ewing on here also.
We are going to have
the best.
Okay.
But first, yes,
Lindsey's going to sit. So we're going to be kind of loosey-goosey in this time. Grant is the star of our film here.
Absolutely.
Hello.
Grant stars as Jefferson, yes.
No.
Lindsey is the star of our film. You see how I did that?
That's I did. It was really good.
Honey, I'm the star of my life.
Lindsey's the star of her life. And so we're going to have them talk about what it was like making the film and their other projects that they're involved with. Ryan's going to try to keep his trap shut, and I'll try to keep my trap shut as well, but we can't help but insert ourselves. We got questions coming in from you guys. Let me bring that up so we make sure.
Insert yourselves.
Yeah.
It's a nice choice of words.
We'll insert ourselves.
Weren't you at that sexual harassment meeting?
Hi, Lorena.
And the main thing is to point out that we love Beanie May.
We heard Beanie May is actually in the hospital right now, and so we just want to send our love and prayers to her. And
this one's for you, Beanie May. Get better.
We're going to leave that up to the whole show because
May. We
love our support. She's a supporter.
Yes.
And
on Kickstarter.
Yes. Our friends over at Paley Anchors told us about. She's Paley Army. So.
Okay.
Beautiful Beanie.
So anyway, this is all for, we're doing it for Spirit Day, we're doing it for Beanie May, and we're doing it for Temps, and we're doing it for you. So we're excited that you're here. I'm going to get out of this chair.
Oh, that's the camera up there.
Yeah, look there.
Okay.
Also, we love you,
Beanie. Looking over there.
Don't look down here.
Also, we love hearing where you guys are from.
I'm getting a text right now.
We love hearing where you guys are from, so write that in you can do it in the YouTube comments.
Right. And so we've got a Q&A up here. We've got YouTube comments. I'm going to be monitoring the YouTube comments and the email as well. We'll be shouting out your questions while these two are chatting.
Why don't you get Reed on before you leave that seat?
Okay, and let's get Reed on. We have Reed Ewing joining us.
Tell us what time it is where you're at.
Is that Reed who just texted me, by the way? Maybe?
Can I come on, please?
He has telephone and computer abilities all at once. Who is this kid?
Who is this Reed?
Who is this Reed?
He's from Utah.
Oh.
The phone with the turquoise.
This one? Purple one? The spirit?
No, that's mine.
That's Lindsey.
Get out of my phone, Ryan.
Let me send
it. Exactly the trouble we had on set.
Ryan, get out of her phone!
Unbelievable! Thanks, Ryan.
Come on, man!
I was always the middleman.
Reed Ewing is in our movie. Okay. As well. Reed Ewing stars in our movie as well as.
That's not true.
Yes, it is true.
I saw you in my dreams.
Did Reed. Was that Reed texting?
1 minute ago. Let me call her.
Call Reed. Link. Tell him I'm sending him the link right now. Okay. We're really.
I don't even know how all of this technology works.
This is what it's really like hanging out with us. Okay.
So all right. Annoying.
How many times?
Grant, you sit here.
Thank you.
Lindsey, show your dress again.
Show your dress again.
Gosh, I'm a lady, Jason.
Hey, babe, show me the dress.
Here.
Come on, show me the dress.
It's beautiful. It's purple. It's for you.
That's right. Hey,
I just wanted to give a shout out to Band of Gypsies, the dress that I wore last week's, Monday. I mean, Monday's podcast.
Where are we?
Webcast. Band of Gypsies is the best. They have such beautiful clothes. And thank you so much.
And look, someone even said hi to us right now. There's Reed right now.
Oh,
Reed!
Where is he? Reed!
They're yelling at you.
I see his picture.
Yeah.
We read.
There he is.
Hey!
Oh my God, he looks so good.
Wait, can we hear him?
What do I do to make him go?
He's going. He's fine, but you have to unmute him, don't you?
I don't know what to do. No, I love you, Reed.
He's just talking.
Oh, do we have
talk, Reed?
Talk, Reed.
Oh.
Are you talking? With words. Because you won't go to your camera unless you talk.
Oh, sorry. I have this.
There he is. You can. I think you can. You hang out now.
Well, he's holding up the phone, but I have speakerphone here.
Beautiful person. I love you.
We can't hear you over the computer.
Oh well, it was working before.
Well, of course it was.
Should we put that?
How can we fix that, Jason?
You look so beautiful and dashing, might I add.
Yeah.
He's got like a Superman curl
but no
right
one
there.
Else can see him.
No one else can see him.
It doesn't matter. His essence is felt. Oh,
we can see you, but no one
we
else
We love
can.
You. I miss you so much, dude.
Oh, we got some highs. Hi, B.
Beautiful dress,
Lindsey.
You're awesome. I really appreciate
she
that.
There he is.
Did that work?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah. Yes.
Well, we can't hear him over the thing, but we think people can see you.
Oh, you're so wonderful.
Can somebody write a comment saying if they can see Reed? On our thing.
I can see Reed, and he looks dang good.
Hey, is that your room?
No.
He would never let anybody into his lair.
Reed is in Salt Lake. Is that where you're at?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Reed, tell them what you do for your job.
It just stopped. Oh, he switched it up.
Oh. No, see, but I'm not.
Oh, we're figuring it out.
Why don't you try... disconnecting and reconnecting, Reed. Yeah, yeah, try it.
You know that it's not you, but we love you. Oh.
Oh, there he goes. He'll be back.
Hey, we got another viewer. Oh, I see how this works. This is so cool. Hey, everyone.
Not that great.
Thank
understand.
You so much, Reed, for being with us. Takes me a minute. It takes me a minute.
Hello.
We text out.
Oh, we got another one. People are talking.
Ooh.
Guys, down.
Oh, Jesus!
There's Reed.
Oh my God, that is so intense. Now you're like the voice of God, dude.
Okay, good. That's
oh, you beautiful man, I love you.
Who are people watching us right now?
We got 62 viewers. The second you came on, it was 62 viewers. We went up.
It went up.
4 viewers.
Cool.
Oh, you're calling it for Reed now.
So, how have you been? What are you doing?
That's confidential.
I mean, you know.
What other questions? Wait, less personal.
Did you get that new earrings, sir?
Yeah.
Are you pierced?
Oh, wow.
So beautiful. I love it.
Looks good.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, no. You know what you'll love even more, Lindsey?
What?
Babies.
What is
my
this?
My crystal gauges.
Oh! No way. Are you serious?
Oh, crystals.
Wow.
Right.
Yeah. Now they go in your ears.
You have gauges? And so oh my gosh, that's so new age.
Hey, you're getting a lot of comments, Reed. A lot of people saying, like, you look dashing.
Yeah, you look
really
good,
you
boy.
Look dashing.
The simple pleasures of life are serving you well.
Well, yeah, that's what Salt Lake City's all about.
Hey, we got anybody from Salt Lake City on here?
You can fake it and say that,
and then
we'll say your name.
I don't know.
I'm just kidding.
I guess people are typing.
Reed.
It's not instantaneous.
Do you want to talk about what was your experience like? How did Temps come over to you?
I had
Well, first off, can I just say I'm wearing this scarf for Spirit Day?
Yay!
I don't really know what Spirit Day is.
It's just for people to be nicer to each other.
Is it like the Holy Spirit?
Of course!
Because I'm definitely down for that.
Of course!
Spirit Day is for to encourage
Spirit Day.
Towards not bullying like teens in the gay, lesbian, transgender community
And
all. But really, it can be encompassed for everybody. Yeah, you know,
it's just being nicer.
We gotta stop putting like, restrictions on who it. Like, just let's all just be nice.
Love each other.
And fair.
All inclusive.
But you look so dashing. Now, how did Temps come to you? Did it drop by Squirk onto your porch?
This doesn't really affect, like, I guess anybody else. But the thing that is really special about Temps for me is that I just can't believe how Ryan casted it. Like, all the people that he casted are like, I don't know. I just liked everybody, and that's really really rare. Like. The people with the small, like, roles in it, and the people with the big roles in it, like, every single person I met was just really humble and personable. And I don't know, that's, like, literally never happened to me ever. So if you guys want to watch a movie with people that I like, then you should see it.
Dude, well said.
Man. Oh, well, you're well a gem.
I don't know if you like them, but... I can assure you I do.
What did you think when you met Grant for the first time?
Well, actually, Grant was the first person of the cast that I met, and I was, like, really impressed by him, you know, talking like you're not here, because a lot of guys are very overly competitive, like, you know, and, like, I just can't, I really can't deal, you know, and Grant is just not, like, in my opinion, he's not like one of these guys who are like too like macho, you know, like he's not overly macho, so I like actually. And he made me really comfortable.
Sorry, go on.
He made me really comfortable in the audition room. It was really easy to act with him. Like I didn't feel like I was like competing with him. I felt like he was kind of helping me act better. So that was that made me want to do the film. After I met the like main lead guy, I was like, okay, I'll do this. Just as long as I'm around people that, you know, aren't making me feel uncomfortable, then I'll be happy to do it.
It's so funny that you say that because when I came on, Ryan already like had you in mind for the role.
Well, Reed auditioned. Reed auditioned like 3 years ago for this. Like he tape auditioned. Now you're on Modern Family or something when you're you shot an audition.
Yeah, and for me it was like I love Modern Family, and so like when you came into the room, it wasn't a competitive thing for me. It was like that's Dylan from Modern Family, and it's you know right. I don't get to work with a whole lot of awesome people like that all the time. So it was really.
Have you guys ever been to Salt Lake City?
I have.
Not really.
Yeah, no. I just say that Reed has literally the most. Inspiring and best work ethics that I have ever worked with. And watching him spontaneously create and come up with things is like watching just a master.
He really
work.
Has
He's such a genius.
I think he has like the most unique way. It's not like a process because it's completely authentic. And like that's the thing that's different from it. A lot of people have methods or whatever, and it kind of feels like they're trying to work through a method. Like for him, it just feels all very authentic. And he just, he always tries to keep. I know that, like, I'm sure I probably frustrate you because I like do 100 takes, and you always like to keep things fresh. And so that's probably, I'm sure people with your stuff.
No, it was just like, but that's mostly because you like, you were like letting us do kind of what we wanted. You know, you weren't like making us do exactly, like to a certain extent. I mean, there were things that you wanted, but for the most part, you let us do what we wanted to do. You know.
Yeah, say that again for Lindsey.
Shut up. Opinions, perspectives.
It was different. I gave Reed more because I understood Reed better because I've worked with Reed before because we did a music video for Modern Family before. So I had a whole experience with Reed before we worked together, and that's what I was saying last time with Lindsey. Like I just didn't have a good base to understand Lindsey, and so that was kind of my fault as a director.
There's never a base.
Yeah. Well, yeah. So read some of the comments.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to figure out. So we got people from let's see, we got Carrie Ridge is from Utah.
Carrie Ridge from Utah.
All
right. Go stalk Reed right now. No, I'm just kidding. Don't do that.
What's your address,
don't
bro? Let's give it to
Reed.
Her now.
The avenues. Oh wait, I wasn't actually supposed to.
Question, Reed. What was it like when you met me and I met you?
Oh, funny story. I was basically begging Lindsey to like me.
And this he expressed to me by literally not looking me in the eye, like not even really meeting him. The first time I really looked Reed in the eye was during this scene where I was like, get behind the camera. Get up. Go on, Reed.
Well, I don't know. I'll tell you, Lindsey, as far as actresses go, I think is like very friendly compared to most of the actresses I've met. So yeah, it was pretty easy.
That's to like talk
to her. You can really say anything, you know. You really don't have to like, you know. It's not like
when Shaw we're talking about.
Shut up.
You know, like it's like, oh, I'm the lead, so you can't talk to me. There's like definitely none of that. Like, she'll talk to anybody, you know. Yeah, so we had a good time, and we hung out a little bit outside of set. Yeah, it was fun. It was like, Temps was really fun. It was like being on vacation. The part of it that we have shot already was like being on vacation.
Which is most of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is pretty much all of it, yeah.
Oh, love this.
Yeah.
And what...
Wait a second. I actually remember the first time you guys met.
Favorite
I remember
scene
that.
To shoot. No, yeah, oh, we yeah. met on a couch where I was like, "Do you got a problem
in
with me?"
In the office. The way Lindsey meets.
You got a do you problem remember this with me?
So the way Lindsey meets yes, people.
If, very, I it's, have very problem.
It's very It's very.
Who are you?
What are you? And it's not like some people when you meet them they're very like you know, they're very extrovert, like hi, hello. When Lindsey meets somebody, it's like, "Are you a good person?"
Yeah.
And honestly, and then Reed was like, dude, I think you're really cool. And I was like, I'm not buying this.
Yeah, you thought I was lying.
I was like, buddy,
She threw a frying pan at me when I said I thought she was cool. So you got lucky.
Listen, I have to really test your, I have to fortify your, you know, yeah. intention for you.
Yeah.
And fire. But no, like, it was one of the greatest meetings I've ever had. Reed was like, no, dude. No, man. I really respect you. And I was like,
I'm harmless. I kept on.
He goes, I'm harmless.
That would describe Reed as harmless.
And from then on, it was, I couldn't get a word in with these two.
Dude, yeah. I love Reed
in a good way.
With my entire soul. He is my
you know,
soul
you
brother
know what's so crazy
here
is
from
like,
another rock.
Like,
I really
Reed,
miss you.
Reed probably wouldn't be in the movie. Like, you... I don't know why you came to LA, but Reed was in Salt Lake, and I asked him to come in for basically like a chemistry read, and his agent, who is not one to write a lot of words, just put when I sent an email.
Most of them are.
I sent like a page long email of like, hey, I knew Reed back when, and we did this thing, and blah blah blah, and all this stuff, and then he wrote back, Reed is pursuing his education in Utah, and that was about it. I think that's what it included. The whole line was like, Reed pursuing his education in Utah. I was like. So I just wrote back, cool, thank you. and then like 3 days later, he wrote back going like, good news, Reed's in town, we'll be at the chemistry read. And I was like, cool, does he know when or where? Or like,
yeah.
Of course he does.
So I don't know, but I just assumed because like he was so cold, I was like, well, this isn't happening. And then so you just like popped in like last day, you know, to come in for those.
Yeah, I'm so glad I did. You know, I just kind of, you know, you have to use a little bit of your intuition for these things or else you'll be going out on auditions every day for, like, shit that you don't even want, you know?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, what that you don't even want?
Oh, you can't. Don't say bad words.
Rolls.
I accidentally cussed, like, 4 times last time.
Yeah, that's really funny. You should do a string of cuss words right now.
Who's gonna do it?
Huh?
Shit! Mother!
What?
Wait, you can say ass, but not. Right?
Wait, Reed, do your beep.
Beep.
I like his. It's like from the 80s.
Wait,
somebody says, I'm totally shipping Lindsey and Grant now. Ha ha ha, you are all adorable, smile.
Do you even
where
know
are you shipping
us? Means?
Like, we're
putting their name together.
No, that doesn't. That is not what a ship is.
What is
a ship
mean?
Is not a name. Yeah. What is a name?
What is
in
a
name?
What is in a name? What is it?
Honestly, a ship is...
I'm totally shipping. That's a ship.
That's a ship.
We're on a boat, and we go fast.
It's the latter half of the word relationship.
Oh.
And they're pretending that in their fan fiction that there's a relationship.
And they're, okay.
Nice. They mean, no, I think they want to ship us somewhere kind of awesome. Which is very beautiful. Right on. Go.
Shipping. Is that what Anchors has to do with shipping?
Haley Anchors has to do more with surviving in this cruel, cruel world. Oh, man. But it also has to do with shipping. Haley.
And I'd like to ship you guys off to Salt Lake City.
What are you doing with that?
Oh, my gosh, Reed. You
have some chances. Wait, what is? What do you have, Reed? What is that?
Look how handsome.
You have to
meet the red carpet.
Ooh.
I keep it by my bed.
Do you kiss it every morning? You wake up, you're like, good morning, Reed. Good morning, Reed.
Reed, I need you to send me one of those ASAP.
Can I have one for unspecified circumstances?
I need you to send me one of those life-size ASAP.
Maybe if somebody donates to our Kickstarter campaign by searching Temps at Kickstarter, then we could send them one of those, Reed. What do you think of that?
Oh, yeah.
Sure, I'll give you anything.
Nice.
Give us...
anything.
More blood than you're allowed to actually give in one sitting.
You know what? We have some...
I don't know how much that is.
We have some new... I could have put up some new thing, rewards.
Ooh, we have new rewards.
New rewards. Here's what. Here's the new rewards, all right? For $175, you can come and join this mayhem, just like Reed, dial into this for 15 minutes and have just us talking to you. That's going to be kind of fun.
I mean, only if you make it that way. It could be the worst experience of your lives, but it won't be.
And if you don't want to be on camera, we could also, I think, do the Google phone thing through it.
We could Google phone. Or you could just ship us.
Or truly, you could just telecommunicate.
Reed, if you want something...
I'm getting something.
You have to talk, otherwise you won't...
I was doing a tarot card reading.
I love I love you beyond anything.
Let me, $200, unlike, I think there's a $100 one for a signed photo, you get personalized, so like with like a special message.
A special message. Is it a fortune? Is it a precaution?
$400.
An admonition.
It could be an extra. We have a few more extra.
Four hundos.
Four hundos. You get to be an extra with these two lovelies right here and possibly Reed. Because if you're in the office, there, we need some for the office scene and for the bar scene. The deal is, though, you'd have to come to Los Angeles or be in Los Angeles November and most likely be on a weekend.
But we
and you have to brush your teeth. Weekend. You have to brush your teeth.
You have to brush. But then you can like take photos with these crazy people. And stuff.
I promise you, I'll like get on your shoulders if you want me to.
It's going
to
be Shree is already going to be an extra.
Shree, shout you out on Twitter. She'll like be like. She'll give you a shout-out on Twitter. She has the most followers, so it's the most...
You.
Oh, yeah.
Oh! But trust me, these people...
I'm basically, volunteering you.
I think there's a question. Or do we need to go through the... Okay, no. Quick question, Reed. What was the most difficult scene to shoot for you?
I was going to ask that. Good question, Valentina Sawan.
Yeah, you got to say her name.
Valentina Sawan.
Well, it was the first day because I was kind of uncomfortable, you know, the first day because, I don't know, it's just you kind of have to, like, get into it, you know. So I think the first day was the most uncomfortable, but everything else after that was awesome.
Aww. Really? Really? Even the day?
You know the day.
Even the day?
Bad day?
Even the day? Reed?
Were you there on the day? He wasn't out there on the day.
No, you know the day, Reed. I'm not going to go into particulars on camera. You know the day.
I don't even know.
I don't know the day.
Wait, you know the... Oh, my gosh.
Reed, what was your first day on set? Do you remember? What scene was that?
The shake. The shake getting...
Oh, gosh. Fired. Wait, did we meet on your first day?
That was your first day?
Yeah. Wow.
Oh, man.
Wait, is that the day we met?
Yeah.
No, I met you in an audition a long time ago, and you didn't remember.
That's right. You said that.
Yeah. Wait, really?
Hey, yeah. Which audition was it?
A long time ago. It was separate, switched at birth.
Oh! We met?
Yeah, yeah.
Who approached who?
I approached you.
Oh, yeah, you did. Yeah, you did. And what'd you say?
I don't know.
Yes, you do.
I don't remember.
Give me your heart and tell me what you said.
I think I said I met you at a party. Nylon or something.
You're saying we could be step siblings.
Yeah. That's what I said. I said we could definitely be step siblings. And then it turns out that...
How long have you been stalking me, Reed?
I wish I was that cool that I was a stalker, but, you know...
Oh my god, your gauges look so... so good.
I care too much about myself to be a stalker.
Oh.
Can we... Let's
the more you know...
If people were to come to Salt Lake City, what would they? Okay, fine. Go on with the prizes. I'll ask.
Well, no, the prize is done, but we're going to thank some people. We're going to thank some of our new donors that have joined on since our last webcast. One of them, Amanda Ward, was just like minutes away from missing. Like I just missed her thing, and she actually donated in the last podcast or webcast.
Oh, right on.
VOD.
But we missed you.
Yeah. Yeah, so Amanda Ward,
right on.
We're going to make a video for her.
Thanks, Amanda.
We're going to make a video for you.
How would you pronounce Maria's last name here?
Mouseth.
Maria Mouseth.
Mouseth, M-A-U-S-E-T-H.
Thank you.
But really, really, it's just Mouseth. A name.
Mouseth.
I don't know.
Oh, they love when you speak Spanish, by the way, Lindsay.
Well, if I knew any more Spanish, I'd speak it, Jason. El gato es en mi pantalones. That has a lot of meaning.
That has many meanings.
SPIRITDAY! SPIRITDAY.
Hashtag Temps movement.
Jennifer Dominguez.
Hey, hi.
Jennifer Dominguez.
Oh, Jennifer Dominguez, thank you so much. Hello.
Thank you,
can
Jennifer.
Can I get a rousing, like...
Thank you,
Jennifer. In fact, let's go on a course. Jennifer. Reed.
Tara Goldman.
Tara Goldman.
Thank you, Tara.
Goldman.
Yeah, and then your friend.
Forget the Goldman. I meant Goldman. God. Thank you so much. We're thanking Tara.
Thank you, Tara.
Thank you, Tara.
Tara, you're the best. Thank you so much. Thank you.
This right here is the United States of Tara. Thank you.
Thank you.
Special thanks to Lindsey Nyman, Ariel Sultan, and T-Shy Froda.
Okay, interrupted people who we never see to thank people that you see all the time.
No, some of these people are New York people that I haven't seen in a really long time.
Thank you, people in New York.
Rude. Thank you, Tara. Thank you all. Lindsey Nyman.
Tara Goldman.
All right.
Hold on.
Oh, look at
Lindsey Nyman. Thanks, girl. Keep working it out of yoga. Ariel, and what's his name?
Look at your
T-Shy.
T-Shy!
Great actor, T-Shy.
Look at your boss.
Thanks, T-Shy.
Corinne?
Yeah.
Corinne, shiny girl!
Thank you.
Where are you at? You were so much fun to work with. And you donated? That's like triple good.
Wow. That's awesome.
You're so wonderful.
Right,
I hope you're doing so well with your baby boys.
Well, yeah, one's like acting up the storm. Like I always see her Facebook posts. Like,
Julie Citron.
Thank you, Julie.
Julie Citron couldn't have done it without you. Temps Movement hashtag. Temps Movement.
Lauren
is
Neves?
Forever indebted to you,
Lauren
but not
Neves?
In property rights.
Lauren Neves, thank you, Lauren Neves.
Lauren. Wonderful. Lauren. Thank you so much. So kind and generous. We really appreciate it here at hashtags Temps Movement.
T. Francis Richardson.
Francis.
I'm a visual learner.
Francis donated? Wow, this movie must be really good.
It's awesome, dude.
T. Francis.
Francis. Wow.
Thank you.
I mean,
so much.
He's progressive, but that's like next level.
Cause, which is the hashtag. I'm sorry, I'm in a thank you, Reed. You need to get on board with these thank yous, man.
Mary Venzel White.
Thank you, Mary.
Mary Venzel White.
Mary! Mary! There's Reed. Something about Mary, and it's that she gave to Temps.
You have anything to say to Mary, Reed?
She wrote a book
thank
called
you, Mary.
And I say thank you as well, Mary. In a very, very large pasture of lamb, I say thank you, Mary.
Kathy B.
Thank you, Kathy B.
Thank you for giving us your money.
And this is kind of cool. Mike Royce, who's like
big time writer. He did the show Enlisted and Men and Their Names.
Enlisted with.
With no Enlisted
with. Purgatory Shadow.
No, Jeff Stoltz. Jeff Stoltz.
No, what's
this? Purgatory Girl.
No, what's this Purgatory
Girl? Oh, the guy, the boyfriend that you're supposed to be. That you should know.
Oh,
that's boyfriend.
That's really bad.
You were his boyfriend.
Listen, I love you.
So, okay, Lindsey wouldn't know my name if I was sitting right here.
Mike might be watching, but I'm sure what's his name's not.
Mike, thank you.
I don't even care if he's
it.
Watching. I just want to spread his candor.
And if you, hold on, Mike, if you're looking for any young 20-something Caucasian males for your next show.
Pick me!
I know I'm good.
Carol Burnett funded us, guys. Like, she knows comedy.
You know what Reed said about him being so humble and not very competitive.
I especially want to thank Mike Royce. Thank you, Mike.
Mike Royce.
Mike,
hey.
Mike and I worked with each other, and he's been
you're really
awesome
cool,
for
Mike
me,
Royce.
He's awesome. I love him.
Yeah, Lindsey was awesome.
And
I love Men of a Certain Age, which is what I worked with him on. So thank you, Mike.
Men of a Certain Age. And what age was that, Jason Duplissea?
I'm only 81.
Jason enjoys long walks on the beach, ladies.
All right.
Jason's mine.
Not anymore. Yeah.
It's okay. I'll.
Did I get that right? Was it Temps?
Since I donated to Temps, my entire life has changed for the better. All your wishes will come true.
Hey, hope spreads around the world, young doing.
Ooh, Lorena is going to update her donation.
All right.
Can't wait to join this madness. Can't wait for you to join the madness.
And if you update, actually, we're going to give you extra love. We'll show the pictures.
What are you going to make me do?
No, of Sheree.
Oh, Sheree
updated her.
What are you going to make me do? Just tell me already.
I'm ready.
What are you going to make me do? Okay.
This is going to be the girl that we're going to write the scene for Lindsey to make out with.
Okay. No, I mean, I'm into it,
but
I don't.
Wait to see her there.
Okay, so this is Sheree. She's going to be an extra.
Oh, Sheree! Beautiful girl.
See?
All about it, girl.
Now, here's the crazy thing. Sheree here, although the Hooter girl, she's also a maximum security prison guard.
Holy crap. Yeah. Get it.
Wow.
Nice.
Show the other picture.
We have an extra and
you are
set
so
security.
Wonderful, like living this beautiful life.
Check this out. Like,
I can't wait to meet you.
Oh,
yes!
My God.
Go, girl.
Look at her gun.
That's what's
pink,
up.
Pink on it.
Ladies in arms. That's what that's
she's even got pink
awesome.
Gun muffs yeah. on.
I
that
think
is
if
so
I died
beautiful.
Getting shot with
right
a pink
on.
Rifle, my life would be simultaneously made and shattered.
Well, I guess that's exactly true.
Anyway, she's... I think,
thank you, Sheree. You're so... I can't wait. Thank you so much.
Yeah,
so
she,
generosity
she
is already, wonderful.
She already had 500.
It's gonna be worth it.
Are you? So wait, you're monitoring the questions?
They're all over the place. So
it's gonna be worth it.
No, it's gonna be worth it on a soul level, just FYI. But also, there might be a thing or a make out. But that's the external part of a connection. So just FYI, I ain't a hoe.
She's not a hoe.
No.
For sure.
I know she's not a hoe. I know.
She's not a hoe.
And here's, I think it's so beautiful.
Here's some other people
beautiful.
I just want to read down the list of.
Oh, yeah, let's read down the list.
I want to read down the list of these other people who were awesome and increased their amount. First of all,
so
Paley Anchors have come through yet again. Last time, they banded together.
Like a little rubber band ball.
There was a lot.
Rubber band.
There was a lot in the last one, and they got $100, and over
that
the last
so cool.
week, they got another $100. They are up to $200.
Dang, go.
They have some new supporters.
Haley Anchors, you rock. Thank you for always.
Tell them, I think it's so cool what they did. They, like 3 years ago, they sent you a book.
Oh, Paley Anchors have sent me so many beautiful cards and letters, just like sharing with me their feelings about how maybe I've made their time on Earth better or easier.
I think it's really
informed.
Cool, like how many people.
And that's exactly what those letters do for me. It's kind of a cool circle thing. So thank you, all of the.
That is the good thing about being on TV is you meet random people you would have never met otherwise.
Very true.
That's like the main thing. That's good about it.
Something really cool over here. Michelle and fellow firefighters here.
Oh, yeah.
Donated $100
they
today?
Did. Yes.
Wow, they're big fans of you from the firehouse.
Yay!
Engine 1.
Oh, my gosh, no way, dudes.
Give it up. That's right. PLL in the firehouse. Right on. Keeping you in your like go mode for when you got to switch in to superhero. That is the most wonderful. I'm so honored. Thank you so much.
Is that Emerald Fan?
Yeah.
That's so cool. Emerald Fan. Michelle and fellow firefighters. How crazy, man. That's what awesome. A crazy job.
You save the lives of people who save lives.
You work in this alchemical atmosphere.
Might be overselling.
Yeah, thanks for your generosity, man. It moves me so much. You know, and it'll be worth it. We're going to feed your soul with this movie, I promise. Yeah. Right, Ryan?
This is really cool. Right. Wait, let me read through the paleo.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Go ahead.
Nicole Jones. Thank you, Nicole Jones.
Jones, is that you giving money to that Kickstarter garbage? Yes, it is. Thank you so much, Nicole Jones.
Oh, yes, it is.
How cool of you. I can't even thank you enough.
Okay, they spelled it out so they could be pronounced.
Camila Madina Go.
And Jason's eating ice cream in the background.
Camila.
I hope that's vegan.
Madina Go.
You know what's so funny? It's like while she figures out the name, Reed has.
I love you.
Okay, well do your love first. Come here.
You're awesome. I did it twice for her.
Okay.
But you peeps were talking about Chinese food in the
background.
We'll
stop talking. You do it.
Camila? Shit! I had it right.
Camila.
Marina go. Tia.
This butchering of your name is for free.
Listen, it's not Camila a butchering of any part of your spirit, and we really Gautier. Thank you here on Spirit Day. Our spirit goes to yours. Everybody, no matter even if they hear the same thing, is always going to have a different perspective on how it's said. So don't hold on to a name. Literally, just like, like literally, there's no association with you in a name. You are not your name. But I respect the name thing. I really do, because I've gotten really upset about that too. But
people screw up Lindsey Shaw all the time.
The point is, like,
it's such a tough
your essence, I so know and feel. So don't feel like gypped, like I don't know you, just because like your name might be from a different part of the world. All right,
let's go to the next one.
So Olivia Shoden.
Olivia.
Olivia Shoden.
You're doing like a
spin. Shoden. Thank you so much. Olivia. We really, really thank Olivia. You're beautiful, and we thank you for it.
Jennifer Dominguez, thank you.
Happy Halloween, Jennifer.
Oh. Are we good on the list?
No, keep going.
Okay.
Janie Stam. Stam, thank you so much. Your money helped the Temps movement.
Really did.
Yeah.
Ildiko Kovas. It's harder.
Ildiko, how you wrote it out to pronounce it
is a harder. Laura Kristen, thank you.
Laura, wait, no, we never said thanks.
Ildiko.
Ildiko, thank you so much for.
Not Ildiko.
Well, you know what, Reed? We work with what we have, and this is what we have, and my heart goes out to you.
What else we got? Natalie Clark.
Now you've skipped Laura again.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Laura? Thank you. No, you're not, because you're not actually thanking anybody.
Well, I'm helping you. I'm
but
they're the
paleo. Point is, it's like, thank you, as a Temps movement, thank you.
From the Temps
Nobody
movement.
Nobody here is more important than anybody else, straight up.
You're part of our family once you donate, that's...
We really, really appreciate everything.
Just like
everything.
Beanie, just like
Laura,
Beanie May is a member of our family here. That's
Christian. Yes, Beanie May.
You can become part of our family
Christian.
By
thank
following
so
us
much.
On Twitter, at
Laura,
Temps Movie, on Instagram, at Temps Movie. Follow us
right.
on
at Temps Move.
Facebook.com. Search for Temps Movie, but the best thing to do is head to our Kickstarter page and just search for Temps there on Kickstarter. There we go.
Laura.
Are you okay, Reed? Can you still hang out?
What is this?
Okay, cool.
Welcome to our dumpster
Reed
fire.
Reed is still alive.
Thank you.
This is our dumpster fire.
I haven't seen these two in forever. It's like
I know. This is such an awesome
okay,
like.
Wait, let's
maybe there's a best media to hang out, but you know, whatever. Work with what we got.
Hey, Reed, hold on one sec. Let her just. There's like three more names here.
Natalie Clark. Natalie Clark, thank you so much. You are literally the reason this is happening. Thank you. AJC. Mysterious. I like that.
Hey, some Paley Anchors are mysterious, by the way. Thank you so much. They're all, like, anonymous, except for they give
me a
list
of names.
So much
gratitude for your contribution.
I don't know who I'm ever talking to.
Jackie, can Lindsey say, okay, cut the cracky, like the French club scene in PLL? Shit. like the French club.
Thank you, Jackie, for that.
Okay, cut the cracky, okay? I did it really, like, straight, right? Shay was the only one speaking fake French. Right. I mean, Emily. Emily.
Yeah.
Okay, cut the cracky. Okay, cut the cracky.
Try doing it in a French accent.
Okay, cut the... Oh,
that's
no.
Not...
See,
cut the cracky.
French, yeah. The accents for me...
Cut the cracky.
I can't pick them. They just come. Anywho. talk
you're
about
good.
What...
Okay. So, yeah, should we do some questions now? Or?
Yeah, Jason's just back. Wait, can we just see Jason back here just
oh,
eating
some ice cream?
Offering us no ice cream. Reed, don't you want some ice cream?
No. I was going to say that.
He's Reed, shaking his head. Reed does not want
to. They had, Reed and Grant had to eat ice cream in the movie, and Reed is a vegan. And
I secretly liked it.
I didn't even think about it. And then, like, later, my wife was like, wow, Reed ate that ice cream. See, I was like, why? He's vegan.
That's what a trooper Reed is, though, that he just ate it anyway.
Yeah,
he didn't say a word.
He didn't even say anything. That was pretty
because we shouldn't put labels on it.
All right, we have more people to think, but we'll do that in a little bit. Let's go to some questions there.
Yes, please. Who's got questions?
Do you have any
okay.
If not, I have some.
Can we, it's kind of hard to keep up with them over here.
Like, Grant... Actually, you can hand, like, the reason I did this entire film was to be in association with this bubba, this, like, man right here, Grant Rosenmeyer. He's going to one day run the Rose Empire. You heard it here first. Hashtag Rose Empire. Hashtag I've now copyrighted your business. Hashtag now you owe me 10%. Hashtag no.
Whoa, how did this happen
Point
so
is,
fast?
Grant is brilliant. He's going to be so brilliant. So, like, handle the questions.
Okay, I'm going to handle
them. Come on,
Rose
Empire.
That was such a wonderful pump-up speech. Let's talk about the most difficult scenes to shoot. Okay. I would say
the ones where my clothes were off.
Yeah, probably because I kept spanking her every time she walked by.
Grant doesn't know this yet, but in fact, nobody knows this yet. This is huge, and the first person who tweets this wins.
Wins the internet.
First one who tweets this wins the internet. On Monday's show,
on Monday. Why don't you say that first?
Yeah, we're doing this on Monday. Monday's show, I'm going to bring here my little laptop and put it like right in front here. And I'm
gonna it's gonna be like this.
Yeah, I'm gonna show these two for the first time their sex scenes together. And then you
this
guys
is not
can
happening.
See, then you guys can see their reactions.
This is so not
it's
happening.
It's gonna be kind of amazing.
No.
And
no, that's not gonna happen.
Yeah,
that's
going
not gonna
happen.
Yeah,
no. Yeah, this is gonna happen because this is a genius idea.
As part of
sure.
Oh, here's a bunch of questions.
Yeah, these are questions from Siobhan. Okay.
Listen,
Siobhan
that's like, happening, Grant. Take yeah. that in. Okay. To your solar plexus.
Reed, don't you think that's a good
chakra.
Idea? Reed, that's a good idea?
I mean, you already have the footage.
Yeah. No, and so...
I think I have a contractual clause or something about
oh
it.
God,
that's why you have to watch
Grant,
first
this
of all.
Is the last time to act precious.
Right, let me...
But see, we're not going to show them it. We're going to... It's showing you guys it. And you guys are going to watch it. And
they're just
going to
see our reaction.
They're going to see the reaction. They don't get to see it.
Oh!
How did men run this country?
Poorly.
Not like well, yeah. Let's poorly. Yeah, not well. yeah, okay, so we got some questions. Where are the questions? Where do they go?
Okay, so anyway, the first person who tweets out that announcement wins.
Yeah, you
and
win.
So
win
I
will literally cut off this chunk of my hair and send it to you. Psych, I'm not doing that. So don't hold me responsible, but that's
I'll
how much I would metaphorically
do. You could send out this autographed Temps Movement hashtag thing, right? Don't you think?
Okay.
Jason.
We can do better.
Oh, wait, some of these questions are really good. Can we get to these?
Yeah, yeah. Okay,
okay.
Hang on one sec. Let me just finish.
I also licked
okay.
this.
Here's the thing with the sex scene thing also.
Now it's mine.
Because let me just explain one thing about this first. When you do a movie and there is sex scenes, generally actors have like clauses in which they have to be have meaningful consultation as far as how it's edited together. So
it's not smut,
yeah,
if you will.
And so I thought it's kind of an interesting thing to do. So I think it's gonna be fun. And then as a prize, we'll do like five people, if we get that many that want to see it. We'll send you out before the movie's out, we'll send you the sex scene. You'll have to sign an NDA because you can't show it anywhere or you'll get sued crazy like. And it'll be your name will be on it, so we'll know if it goes out.
Most of all, we'll just be disappointed, which will weigh on you for the rest of your life.
Having Lindsey Shaw disappointed at you is kind of major. I've had that personal experience.
Really, I can never be disappointed.
I have some questions about this whole thing.
You don't need to worry about that.
Okay.
So these are questions from Siobhan from last time, who she's the one that reminded me about today being Spirit Day. So thank you.
Right on. So Spirit Day.
First question. Do you think that actors can be a bit pampered? Does everyone on the crew work just as hard, potentially for less credit? Yes, 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 and yes. Do you have anything to?
No, I have nothing to say on
this. Well, here's the thing: is that we weren't so pampered on this one just because it was pretty low budget. So
there's different levels of movies.
Yeah.
This one, it requires more work from everyone. There's no one that gets, because there's so few people. I mean, from PA up to Jason, like Jason's like bringing in like craft services and stuff, and then Rich is like bringing in everything, you know, like.
Reed, what is your take on this?
Yeah, what do you have to?
Okay, well, I was waiting for you to ask, but thought you'd never ask. No, I don't think that actors are pampered. I really don't. I think that it's just sort of, you know, I mean, like, they just have their, like, personalities, you know, but I wouldn't say pampered, definitely not. Like, most actors, I think, are actually pretty humble, for the most part. I think they're pretty, I mean, I don't know, like, maybe it doesn't seem like they are, but I think, like, they kind of are, for the most part.
Whenever they're not, I find it's out of insecurity, because, first of all, it's a very nerve-wracking thing to go up and put yourself in front of a crew you don't know, and try to perform an emotion that you're not sure you can get to, or connect with somebody you're not sure you can connect to. And Lindsey, do you have a question?
No, I have a comment.
Okay.
Here's the pen. We'll pass around the pen.
There is always, always, always a balance to everything. But the acting profession deals with materials that are felt inside the body that a lot of people don't feel. A lot of people only feel when they're in front of the TV and they have an emotional reaction. Emotions don't come out of people, just like people are vulnerable and intimate when they watch TV. So the point is, when you're on set, being pampered literally just means being acknowledged and like literally creating, the entire crew creates part of the net that you're trying to sew together. You know what I'm saying? And so you just have to be taken care of to be able to stay in a state where you can completely be on the edge of everything. Yes, acting is dramatic, of course, because it's a reflection of our own lives. So to be available to those emotions, to actually do your work impactfully, which is really the only reason we do this, is to remind other people that they can feel, it's really like kind of a mind fuck of a job. Excuse my language. And
it is a mind F of a job.
Being pampered, of course there's limits, but like there's a reason.
So yeah, and as far as yes, actors can be pampered on some shoots, and then there's actual pampering where, you know, you hear about just all sorts of crazy, like, actors getting green M&Ms only, and then on this one,
I don't even know.
We couldn't afford
evidence.
So, you know, it was just like, yeah, and people. Yeah, I think that when it comes down to pampering,
but I think what she's saying is really important, like, that you have to build a space for you guys to perform and to get there. So it's not like a extravagant thing to be pampered, because you don't want their mind space to be just like what me and Lindsey talked about last time. Part of the problem was that her mind space was taken up with trying to acting, and then we threw extra stuff on top of her, and that's what made it difficult. And it's like, when you're an actor, you want your sole focus to be on what you're trying to communicate and what emotions you're trying to get across. And so any way that the crew can help to achieve that is the best case scenario.
Absolutely. And forming your own bonds with every single person in the crew.
Right.
Totally.
I mean, the whole point of everyone being there is for the actors to perform. That's the whole point.
And all of that energy goes into their performance. So it's like, it's not so much pampered as having this amazing camaraderie, like, between everybody, where
I don't know. Actors are treated preciously, because seriously, if you get mad at them, that could freaking mess up your whole day. You know what I mean? Actors get their feelings hurt, man. It's all about feelings. Don't hurt my feelings!
I know about this.
And also, all actors are different. Some actors need more attention than others, and, you know, and it's, I mean, it's just like a very unique, everybody has a unique way of working, so, yeah.
One quick comment, apparently, it's supposed to be cut the crap, Jackie, not cut the cracky. Cut the crap, Jackie.
But she liked
cut the crap. I like cut the cracky.
I know.
Cut the crap, Jackie. Cut the crap. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I remember that line. I was like, what? Cut the crap, Jackie.
Hey, Reed, can you say something? We haven't seen you in a while.
Really? Haven't you seen me the whole time?
No. Like, just cannot take my eyes off of you.
Only when you speak.
Well, what do I say? Like,
I see you tiny. We see you tiny, and then we see you big. Then we see you tiny, and then we see you big.
A lot of the, like, yeah, when you talk, Reed, the camera automatically switches to you, and then you're featured. So when you're not talking, you're...
Oh, my gosh. So I can just keep on going like this. And
Now you're up.
Oh, ready? Hey, what's up, guys? I'm talking.
Now you're back on, and now I'm on, because I'm interrupting you.
Because you're loud. It's freaking obnoxious.
Rude, Ryan. That's what I mean by hurting feelings. You can't hurt our feelings like that.
What percent of the 90% of us being nice to each other for spirit?
Yeah, we tried, guys. We tried.
I have 10% of meanness.
10%.
Okay, Siobhan wants to know if I... she says, first of all, that she loves mine and Lindsay's relationship. This is based on our last exchange again. You can check that on YouTube if you haven't seen it. You're almost like brother and sister.
Right on.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Keep pushing each other's buttons.
buttons.
Do you want to get know Lindsay better, and would you want to work with her in future projects?
I would be laughing for.
I would like to get to know Lindsay better.
You too.
She's pretty much an open book, though. Lindsay's an open book. You kind of get what you see, you know?
I think Reed and Lindsay are actually very similar in a lot of ways.
I agree with that, for sure. Like, Lindsay and I are very similar.
Yeah, it's just all, like, you guys don't, like, there's no BS with you.
You let it all hang out.
Yeah.
With me, there's just, like, nothing
to
BS.
The only difference is Reed is mad at me as often.
Because Reed secretly knows that he's a ninja and he's going to do everything he wants anyway, which always turns out so brilliant. I'm not saying without your direction.
This is a good one, too. Is it common for the director and actors not to get on well?
I think it's common for the director and actors not to get intimate. And the point is, whether you can do that by being nice to each other or whether maybe you have to, like, raise the volume a little bit, go through some different chakras and vibrations with each other, the point is you need to get to a place of intimacy.
It's a challenge. I mean, like, you're both challenging each other because you both want better. Like, they want to be the best they possibly can, so they want as truthful feedback as possible.
Exactly. That's what it comes back around to. It's like, bring me to my fullest potential. Like, are you, you know, it's just trusting somebody to
that's where I was saying I was failing before, because if I don't know limits, I don't know how far I can
go. I don't know if you're failing.
No, you were never failing. We had some really brilliant moments where your direction totally diffused everything and made scenes exactly what they needed to be, you know?
It all turned out, man. It always works. Well, it doesn't always work.
No, it doesn't, dude.
This one, it really...
It doesn't always work out. We are special.
My shit always works.
So does mine, so...
Yeah, so that's when you put us together, you're going to have something that works.
But honestly, it was a little bloody.
It was, but it was good.
It's beautiful.
It was just extra stress, I think, on both of us, but it came out all good. And I think when we do it again...
Like, every day we would start and just be like, hey, and, like, have a camaraderie, like, around the breakfast table or something, like, start the new day. And then just as the day would progress, it was just a really heavy movie to make. And I think it's because I was, like, you know, this really light, feminine character of Stephanie, and I was just like, I need to let the rage out.
Yeah, but, you know, it's like... I don't know, like, if you watch the movie, you know you're watching a bunch of sweethearts.
Oh! Like,
it's true, though. Eden and Lindsay and Grant and me, like, you don't... Like, seriously.
Isn't that a crazy good cast? I mean,
it's so good.
Like, and such a, like, people I don't think understand, like, when you do movies, like, a lot of times the cast doesn't get along that great, and, like, we could all hang out together.
We won't.
Because why?
Because people don't do that.
Because Eden works like every single day, like 20-hour days.
Listen, I'm going to dig a tunnel for Reed to get here. Somehow I'll get Eden on board. We're going to have a barbecue.
Emily Victoria's going to update her. She's going to have to update
her. Oh, yeah. Emily Victoria Aronson, is that her?
Yeah.
By the way.
Emmy Victoria.
I'm eating brains.
Stop. You always try to put shit all the way in your mouth.
Let's not get into that.
I swear to God, the first time I met Grant, he put my little dog's face completely into his mouth.
Your dog's head is so small, though. It's so tempting.
No. I really want like a little.
Unbelievable. Like the gall.
Reed has an amazing dog.
Reed has the best dog.
Oh.
What's
hold on. Ooh, okay,
what's
what is
dog's
it?
Name? Reed.
Oh.
Reed.
My dog?
Yeah.
Rocky.
Rocky
came on set lots of times.
Rocky was the best.
Oh man, he just made. He was like the on-set therapist. You just come and you go in your corner and it's like, well, it's such a long day, and let me just pet you. I just want to pet you. God, it's just something better.
Reed and Rocky were cute as corn cobs on that set together, just beating each other around to stay.
We're just
food.
Inseparable. A little bunny.
Do you want to put where they're from?
Oh, yeah. We have some people.
Read some places.
Hey, do you think we could switch dogs, Reed?
An hour. France. We got people from France.
Lindsey, pronounce my last name correctly. In her defense, people mess it up in Spanish. Wait.
Hold on. Let's read.
Oh, yeah, I'm so glad. Camila.
Yeah.
Camila.
Did she say you spelled it?
Yeah, no,
right?
She said she
got
pronounced
right.
My last name correctly.
Oh,
one of
nice.
Those times.
Nice.
You're a beautiful
awesome.
Woman. Thank you.
Hi from France.
By my side.
Hello.
You know, it's like
Julie?
Is it 4 or 5 in the morning in France?
Now it's like 6 a.m.
I stay up late.
Yeah, they're like, we should do this again at 2 a.m. I think that'd be pretty fun.
I think that'd get the crowd we really need.
You gotta
for
check
this.
Your framing, Reed. All we see is your forehead.
I like
maybe that's
forehead.
All he wants us to see.
Yeah. Do we?
Yeah, it's an artistic decision.
Parker Young! Yeah. Thank you so much, Lorena Mason.
This
Lorena
live
Mason,
question
Lorena
thing is
Mason,
awesome.
Lorena Mason,
this is so
you're a
cool.
Genius.
Yeah,
Parker cool. Young, so sorry I forgot your name, not your essence. You were an enlisted on Fox.
Oh.
While you were doing Suburgatory the last season. Beautiful. You're amazing.
Oh, okay. By the way, crazy story, and I meant to tell you. So you're just talking about Devin Werkheiser, right?
I mean, briefly.
Yeah, on this thing. I just saw him the other day. And he says
in
hi.
In the flesh?
Yeah, in the flesh. I saw him at an audition.
Wow.
Yeah, he's doing great. He looks awesome.
Did
he looks
you put
really,
did,
very svelte.
He's literally transformed into the most evolved, wonderful version of himself. So
really nice guy. Really nice guy. I think I met him like a long time ago.
He's right. Okay.
See if there's a couple. One
more question.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one.
And then we'll do some.
Is Eden Scheer as hilarious as she seems?
More hilarious.
Completely more.
Yeah.
Absolutely the best.
And just
ever.
So down.
Unbelievable.
Like it's
hilarious.
It's pretty funny when she came on set the first time. First of all, you have to the set is not much bigger than us right here in the room. And like. Clearly,
sometimes smaller.
Yeah, clearly she comes from a big show, and I think I was like, she's like, oh, I've done low budget things before, but nothing this small. She was so awesome.
She was so cool, man.
Just unfazed by everything.
True artiste and woman, just doing it for the world. Go Eden Scheer.
Oh wow! Now we got a bunch of
so awesome
stuff.
True.
Wow, what are we going to do, Grant? Were you even listening about Eden?
Yeah, of course I was listening about Eden. Who's Eden?
Oh, Grant.
He played a wonderful Jefferson.
Yeah.
You'll see what I mean.
Let me I played Jefferson.
And then
who's
you'll
Eden?
Think back to when I said this and you'll think.
Hi, Lorena.
She was right. Lorena.
I saw something about panties.
What's the question?
Someone wanted to know about the scene where Lindsey... That we posted on Instagram about Stephanie pinching the panties.
Reed, you are brilliant, and so are you.
That was Reed that killed
is
that
such
scene.
No,
thank
we
you,
all
I don't
killed
know,
that
I,
scene.
I bet Reed hasn't even seen it. Have you seen that, Reed?
I haven't. No.
Yeah.
I don't remember it.
No, it was you do remember it.
It was
a little.
We were doing
it was,
you do remember.
You
do
remember.
You remember right now.
It was the.
I'm trying to think. Like what happened?
It was a seance scene for
Oh, right.
For Allison Siegel.
Allison Siegel.
Allison Siegel. Yeah. Right.
And then the panty thing.
We tried to like kind of emulate the craft. So you'll like Temps.
That was like actually that scene, there was two scenes that are similar that we shot back to back, and that was the one actually as a director I think that I laughed the most. Like I kept breaking, like laughing over it, like Reed would keep on making up stuff and like
like while we were shooting it?
Like we're
oh,
like,
oh man.
You're like I'm gonna miss you. What was the other girl's name?
Oh no.
It starts with the S's eating outward
something Isabel Rossellini teeth.
Yeah.
Natalie Simmons. Natalie Snackletooth Simmons.
Yeah. I will always miss you.
Nobody understands what we're talking about. But that's okay. You will. In 10 months. Whatever.
As long as we get it funded, you will.
Oh, yeah.
Going to Kickstarter.com and searching for attempts.
Is it? I think you got it. Yeah, I get this.
While we're there, let me just thank a few more people. These are people that increase their thing. And again, if you increase your money, if you've already donated, you want to...
Sorry.
Wow.
What happened? Woo. Said to get the pen.
Where was the pen?
Oh, it was...
Brent!
Was, down.
God damn it! Jeez!
This pen is a prize.
Let's say some thank yous.
I'll put it in the
prize. $1,000!
Put it in this plastic Ziploc.
Oh, yeah, Reed, I love you. We have all right. The same planet.
So like, Cherie, how we showed her pictures and stuff, if you guys up your money... We'll show pictures. Like if you do a drawing or something. I know like people like to do drawings of Lindsey and stuff. We'll show that, or we'll
hold your picture next to Lindsey. Thank you.
We'll do some awesome stuff. So if you up your money, we're going to do some awesome stuff. So I want to thank the people that have.
We're already doing awesome stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
Siobhan, first of all, who again was the one that pointed out Spirit Day. Thank you, Siobhan.
Thank you, Spirit Day. All of your spirit, all of your Siobhan, money, all of your potential, all of everything. You've signed it all to us, right?
My brother and sister.
Thank you.
Well, brother-in-law and sister.
And brother-in-law. Only in-law. And sister. You
brother.
Rock.
Like
thank
brother.
You so
in-law.
Much.
Brother.
I mean...
Angela and Whit Larson.
Who?
Thanks, Angela, Larson
that's
family.
That's my...
Angela?
That's my sister.
No, I just was...
Oh,
I,
you're
I was
talking. You're talking. Sorry.
Trying to hear the name correctly, so I'm not like, meow, 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 meow. Angela, thank you so much. It's the one with the brother-in-law or different one?
No, same one.
Angela. Oh, right on. Angela and brother-in-law.
Angela Sage Larson.
Oh, I like the hyphenated last name.
Brooke Hyatt.
Thanks, Brooke.
And actually, I think she has like two things going. So she's really awesome.
Sage Hyatt.
She might even have a sister. Yeah, Brooke Hyatt. Yeah, you may know
Brooke
this
Hyatt.
Person.
Thank you so much, Brooke Hyatt.
Emmy Victoria,
you're awesome.
Who like ups her money
thank
like
you.
On an hourly basis.
Emmy Victoria wants to know if you're practicing your Norwegian, Grant, since you're going to Norway.
Emmy Victoria.
Oh, yeah,
I am practicing
it, but I'm not going to say any yet because it's not good yet.
I was going to try.
Fjord,
though.
Fjord.
Fjord.
That's what I got.
You know, Emmy speaks like six languages. Let me tell you, like,
oh God.
I'm gonna feel so stupid.
I'm gonna feel so.
And she has a very good American accent, first of all.
Ooh.
Yeah,
she should be in the movie.
She's
hello, I'm an American. That's my American accent.
It's pretty good.
She can
it sounds like you're American. That's so weird.
She can speak Norwegian, Swedish, and Danish, and English and French. And she's taking Chinese right now. So.
You can speak.
Oh yeah. Do you speak Chinese, right? Aren't you taking Chinese classes?
It's Korean, Ryan.
Wow.
Ooh.
Watch
wow.
The language, man.
We got kids present.
Sorry.
God.
That was such a disappointment to Reed. I feel so bad.
I knew it was Korean.
Reed is not disappointed by much.
No, but he's...
Actually.
Hey, Reed, somebody's tweeted their dogs watching you on our webcast.
Oh, my God.
What is that?
Cheese.
Here, get closer so that
Lorena Mason's dogs are watching you on our on the Temps webcast.
And by the way, Lorena is also a person that upped her money. So thank you, Lorena.
Thank you, Lorena.
And
you're
your dogs,
awesome.
Too, because your dogs probably can't eat now.
And your little dogs, too.
Oh, my gosh. I could bring my puppy here right now if I felt like getting up.
Go get it. Oh.
Go get Raggy.
I mean, why not? We'll do it.
Come get Raggy's. Yeah.
Okay, Valentina.
Valentina, you're the best girl. Thanks for tuning in and for donating.
Laura May, after money.
Laura May, wow. How cool of you. Glad thank we inspired Laura. You, so we appreciate it.
Christine Hansen.
Christine!
Thank you, Christine!
Christine, you are the best.
Laura Gutierrez.
Laura Gutierrez.
Melissa gracias. Blasco.
Thank you so much. Melissa Blasco, you're the best. Thank you for your money. We really, really needed that and appreciate it.
And my good friend Cheryl Beasley.
Cheryl
what up, Cheryl? Beasley. Thank you, Cheryl.
Your donation
what up,
Cheryl? Yo, is Cheryl. On.
Cheryl.
On. Cheryl!
Racky!
Not Racky. This is a baby dog that we got pretty recent. He's a year old. Yeah.
No, Racky and him don't look the same.
This is a baby.
Oh, he's so cute.
Okay, but you need to talk, Reed, so we can all see the dog.
Yeah, you gotta keep talking.
I'm talking with Odie right here.
Hey, oh! Yeah. Sorry, talk again, Reed.
Okay, I'm talking. With Mr. Odie, look over there, Odie. Look at the camera. Okay, I'm talking. Okay, now you see him.
All right.
Reed is like five. How many dogs do you have, Reed?
Four.
Two more names here. Seabrook.
I need to come Siobhan visit that Oliver. Baby pup. Okay,
maybe we did everyone. Siobhan, Oliver, Kylie.
Yep. I need to come visit that baby pup.
Oh, Kylie Schmidt, who I think she said we messed up her name, her last name.
Wait.
Kylie Schmidt.
Kylie Schmidt.
Thank you, Kylie.
Right? Kylie?
Where's Kylie?
I'm sorry. You know that the sentiment is still the same, right? That we love and adore you?
Lindsay, how did you and Grant become roommates before?
Well, it was this really creepy roommate Craigslist roulette situation. I don't know. You answer that, Grant.
So Lindsay and I have a mutual friend named Taylor Emerson. Taylor!
He's in the same fraternity as Rich.
Yeah. Sigma Chi.
Rich Inman,
anyway,
who sent in a question to last week's webcast and was also
God,
one of the best.
This is the most ADD thing ever.
Assistant Sunset Weaver.
Yeah, Rich rocks. Hi, Rich.
Hi, Rich.
Oh, wait, we have a new backer.
Hi, backer. Well, let me finish answering the question.
Okay,
we met through him. I was on a show called Oliver Bean with Taylor, who knew her for a very long time, introduced me to this young lady. And we all just went off like gangbusters, and we're like, we all have to live together. And so we did.
And then we all grew to hate each other, which is not a bad thing, okay? Because then we grew so close that we wanted to do this movie together.
Can't hate without love. I don't hate Taylor.
No.
I love you.
I just needed a minute.
By the way,
we all
you texted
each
me,
other.
And I'm sorry I did not respond. It was a weird
day.
Yeah,
me too. I'm sorry.
I'm sure he's watching.
He might be.
It doesn't matter.
But it could be. It's on YouTube forever. Yes.
Manez Gitzman Bruno. Is that right?
Ooh.
Special thanks because they just donated right now.
Muniz?
Write in, tell us how bad we're saying your name right now.
Gritzman Bruno.
Moneys?
Bruno Gritzman Moneys. Moneys.
Thank you very much.
You're
really
the best.
Appreciate it.
That's seriously.
That's so cool. Thank you.
We could not do it without you. It's a movement, guys. We're all doing it, and thank you. And gals and guys, take labels off it.
I want to see. Look at this. Here's our Kickstarter thing.
Coming in.
Can you see that? Is it focusing?
See
that little blue triangle thing? We're headed in the right direction. We got to get up to this green line, and right now we're just about on track.
Awesome.
So thank you, everyone. So
whenever
cool.
You guys say Rocky, I think of the Rocky Horror Picture Show and expect you all to start saying...
It's not Rocky, it's Racky.
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 It's Racky with an A, but the Rocky Horror Picture Show is also pretty cool. I mean, gotta say, that's good too.
Oh. Does everybody not just, like, want to give Reed the hugest hug that you ever thought even possible of giving?
Thanks, Lindsay.
I mean, I know. Is that just me overwhelmingly being inappropriate again? Well, it's worth it.
It's good that nobody can see me doing the time warp.
I'll do the time warp again.
If you want me to do the time warp again?
Let's do the time warp again!
Oh, God. My... No.
I need to tie it.
Woo-hoo!
Whoa, dang, this just got heated.
There you go.
That was good, though.
It's the time. Hey, my pleasure. I used to act.
Me too. That, but I want to know about the girl's panties that keeps in her closet. Page lady killer. More about the panties.
We should. Oh, I have those panties.
Pants. Yeah, you should, like, if you donate enough, you get them. You get the pants.
I don't have those panties.
Anymore. I do. I have
to put them on.
It's late everywhere, right, guys?
It's only 6 o'clock in the morning for one of these people.
Well, it ain't ever too early, is it?
Hey, question. Okay. I just want to ask you guys, why did 30 of you not tune in tonight?
Why did 30?
This is the ones
because,
who didn't.
You know why? Because we didn't promote it as much as we did the last one because we're a day closer.
Well, yeah.
But the next one watch is going to be a lot because you guys are going to watch your sex scenes.
Well, it's okay. Oh, I got viewers leaving just after I said that. Listen, I only ask that because...
You can't yell at the students that show up to class.
Oh, I'm not yelling at any students, my friend. These are not my students. These are my, like...
These are not my students.
The point is...
You are my student, actually, you guys.
I miss you. But I need to practice gratitude. Thank you to all who are hearing this broadcast.
We're happy
I'm feeling it.
Oh, really, Valentina. Really Valentina says, don't remember from Monday.
No.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, I do, Valentina. I said thanks for tuning in last week. And
because we upped her
this week,
and upped her money.
I said thank you, but I totally did that with recognition. I would willing to put Grant's life on that. So, Valentina, come on, don't be like that, girl.
Well, here,
don't
be like that.
You know, we know.
Here's a little comment from Sporty Spunk 97.
Oh boy,
Lindsay, it's a shout out from Husker Nation.
Oh, thank you, homeland.
You make her proud. Reed, she says that she misses you on Modern Family every week.
Hear, hear.
And Grant, you are hilarious.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yes.
Spunky what?
We also have to say
Sporty Spunk.
Thank you to Zane Chang because
thank you.
Yeah.
No,
thank you, Z.
Spunk. Z
Chang because apparently they put down Terry Goldman, but it's not Terry Goldman, it's Z Chang.
Z Chang?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's my fault.
I know who that is.
Thank you so much.
You?
Thanks, Z. You rock.
Is there anybody out there that I know personally? Can you do like a hello or something?
If anyone knows Reed, write in now.
Yeah. Like, are any of our friends watching?
No, because you know what?
We don't have
any friends anymore.
That's why we're actors and directors and stuff. Because we can hire people.
There you go.
To be our friends. We can hire people to be our friends. You said it.
We already thanked Claire. Chinookanoo?
I think so.
I don't think we thanked Claire tonight. Thank you, Claire. Thank you, Claire, for all that you were willing to bear for this crazy, crazy cause.
Leah Elena?
Thank you, Leah.
Leah Elena.
Is it Leah L-I-A? Is that Leah? L-I-A.
Yeah, Tim Bennett, the writer.
Oh, the writer.
Who?
Would like that for the next hangout. He just wants Odie.
Hear, hear.
Tim Bennett is awesome.
Odie, aw. You know his name. Odie.
Love you.
Odie, come here.
Yeah, can we just stare at Odie for the next one just for like an hour? Just Odie.
Okay, and then we already thanked Michelle and her fellow firefighters.
You're the best.
Alyssa Montgomery.
Oh, thank you, Alyssa Montgomery.
Thank you, Alyssa Montgomery.
Alyssa Montgomery, I'm sorry. I thought I felt an earthquake just now. I don't know why. I think I just jerked on my own chair. Well,
I fucked up.
Alyssa.
I think
Alyssa
You'll
Montgomery.
And then Rand.
Thank you, Alyssa Montgomery. You're awesome.
Ran Lee.
Ron.
I know Ron. Dude,
thank you so much.
And also thank you for sharing on Facebook, Ron. I really appreciate it.
Wow.
I just
the
saw
people
that.
Grant
thank
knows
you.
Are the only people he really likes.
Oh, that's not true.
You guys out there need relationship advice because we could definitely supply you with relationship advice.
You look so hot with your gauges, I can't even take it.
So damn hot. That's a sexy man.
That is a...
That's not relationship advice, but you know, I'm just saying, it could get interesting.
Carmen Cordova.
Carmen Cordova, you are wonderful. Thank you for your generosity.
Thank you, Carmen.
Three more people. Tina Skag, S-K-A-U-G, Skag.
Thank you, Tina.
Tina? Tina with a T and an I and an N-A. Hey, do you watch Tina from Bob's Burgers? Tina, Tina, you are the best. I was Tina for Halloween.
Okay, I remember that. This is a great, so I have a great much. Picture. Wait, we should auction off that picture. That was a hilarious picture. I
yeah, we
it.
Should.
Yeah.
We should sell it to Tina for however much she wants to buy it for.
Bob!
Bobby.
Bobby!
Janie?
Is it Janie?
Janie.
Janie. We think Janie Stan.
I know. She's both a Paley anchor and our own private donor. So she's a double whammy, special super mommy.
Holy awesome crap. Thing. I cannot tell you how much we thank you, Janie.
It's pretty darn cool.
It's really just overwhelming to feel so much love from the world. So thank you.
Like, we are so excited actually to have all these. Because kind of the cool thing for us is, like, normally you go off in a little group and you make a thing and you don't really get the experience until you project it on a screen with an audience. And it's kind of fun to have all you guys coming along for the ride and, like, being able to be a part. I mean, like, Temps Movement is kind of hokey or whatever, but it's actually a true thing, like, where I really feel like there's a group, a core fan group of all of us, like, moving together to do something, and we really appreciate that. I think
thank you.
This is so cool. Honestly, we really appreciate all the love and support. The last person is my boss, Tracy Grandstaff, one of my bosses.
Thank you, Tracy!
Tracy, awesome. You rock. Thank you so much.
Don't fire Ryan!
Or do.
Is he a good worker?
No, don't.
Is he a good worker?
I'm kidding.
That's half the money to the movie.
Astrid says it's 6 a.m. over there. That's pretty cool.
I was kidding.
Where's the 6 a.m.?
Astrid says, in Belgium.
Belgium.
Wow.
This is actually, this is the other cool thing, I mean, you guys are all around the world. This is crazy. They're like,
yeah, we've got Nana back from Dar es Salaam. She's doing the dishes.
Oh, good. Oh.
Yeah, girl.
Clean it up.
Clean those
dishes. Get it lightened, and then you do the dishes.
Are they watching this while
we should do Screw, Marry, Kill with Lindsey Grant and me. Screw, Marry, Kill.
Oh, I'm afraid of this.
Well,
I'm just saying. You better marry me.
Done.
Yeah, Ryan.
What?
Screw, Marry, Kill.
Oh, yeah, Ryan. Screw, Marry, Kill.
Yeah, there you go.
Who?
Me, Reed, or Lindsey.
Oh, okay.
Wow. Wait, Lindsey should answer this. That puts Ryan in a compromising position. Okay, Lindsey, you answer.
Oh, finish, because Ryan is now saying that he would screw me, and I'm very curious.
Oh, my God, of course you are.
Spirit Day. We can say whatever we want.
Spirit Day, yeah, and kindness. And then kindness. Screw, marry, or kill?
Mm-hmm. You gotta marry one of them, you gotta kill one of them.
I always knew Graham was your favorite.
Although, who do you want to marry?
Yeah, can I take it back?
I want to just be screwed and left. That sounds terrible.
No. Welcome to women.
This is too tough. I'm already married. I'm happily married. So.
To a beautiful wife.
Oh, happily.
They helped me.
I thought it was whole way.
the clapboard thing.
They did it. Your son did it expertly. Will?
Yeah, Will.
Will. He did expert. Amazing. Expert technician. And
Nicholas?
Nicholas.
Nice! That's pretty cool.
Nicholas. Just a little ray of joy, son. And what a strong woman your wife is. I only, like, felt her presence, like, when she came on set. But I would absolutely love to come over for dinner. Anytime that's good for you, girl.
Hey, 5:57.
Why don't we talk a little bit about the movie, Temps?
Okay.
What?
For those of you who don't know anything about the movie,
we're a bunch of professional
actors
playing temporary.
Was there anything?
Actors.
Was there more to that?
Well, I wanted you guys to talk about it. I mean, I can talk about the movie.
Well,
Grant and Reed play.
We play ski bum Temps.
Yeah, let's talk about Reed,
can you just talk about Modern Family, because, like, everyone loves that show, and talk about, like, because originally you were just in the pilot, and then you were so awesome, Steve Levitan, who also was the creator of Oliver Bean. This is like a little circle thing.
Great guy.
Circle.
No, stop. And
drum circle.
So he, I mean, like, and he was really cool.
I'm marrying her.
like, here's some fun facts. Like, the car in Modern Family is actually Reed's car.
Yeah.
That's in the show. And you wrote, like, the song that we did the music video for yourself, right?
Yeah, I did write the songs. It's been pretty crazy, you know, like, doing that show. It's, like, super always exciting. Oh, is this better?
Yep.
There you go.
There you go. Sorry. Yeah, it's pretty much what you would expect, I guess. Like, I don't know. Like, you go on set, you film scenes, you chat a little, you get paid. That's pretty much it.
Isn't it weird how, like, Ty Burrell is such an asshole? I mean, like, he's just so mean.
Are you asking me that, like, for real, or?
No, I'm kidding. He's, like, one of the nicest
guys. You want to know what's really funny is I did my first gig ever when I was, like, 8 years old. I did a Macbeth on Broadway with Ty Burrell.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that was like 12 years ago.
Who did he play?
I played the son of Macduff. I get stabbed. It was awesome. I've done two Broadway shows, and I died in both of them. And I was like 9. It's cool.
I once did community theater.
Oh, yeah?
Grand Brilliant. The Rosenmeyer, yeah, I'm telling you.
But Reed, talk about, like, because I know that, like, you came down and, like, you really busted your ass trying to get a part and stuff. Like, you did a lot of auditioning and stuff before.
Oh, yeah, okay, fine. I'll like, do some story time right here. I moved to L.A. when I was 17 to become an actor. I got into a Disney pilot that didn't end up getting picked up. So that means the show never got produced, but I did get a good role in it, and then Modern Family the next year, and then, you know, they just kind of had me off and on that show, and yeah, that's pretty much it, and then I just did whatever else came my way.
Wow, you're so brilliant. That's so cool. I didn't know that you started out on Disney. I mean, like, did a pilot for Disney? That's crazy.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's about monster trucks. I was a monster truck driver.
No way.
Yeah, I was a redneck monster truck driver.
Gosh, I bet you killed it. I see it. It's awesome.
Yeah.
Ooh, wait, here's a question over here.
Lindsey, have you ever wanted to kiss Grant or anyone out of set?
Huh.
I have kissed Grant out of set.
And don't forget, Lindsey. No, I'm just kidding. She forgot.
Lindsey kissed everyone.
I kind of I thought that we were doing resuscitation training.
We took a class. It was a class.
I love Grandy so much. He's so brilliant. Lindsey, and we have shared a speech.
When did you actually
102?
I don't
know. We were drunk.
I don't know
drunk
at night. Story. Lindsey, how did you start acting?
Well, I was hatched from my egg, rolled onto Hollywood Boulevard and said, I want to act. Take me to the casting place where I would procure such a job. And I don't know, dude. I just moved out here when I was 12. Fate brought me. I don't know. I feel like I've explained this story 1,000 times. I don't really know the story. It's weird. It gets, like, less clear as I tell it, but whatever. I just,
because,
like,
it just becomes a story, right? It's weird.
It just becomes just, like, yeah, yeah. That's exactly it. But, you know, it was just destiny. You know what I mean? So I got out here when I was 12, managed to stay, and now I'm still here, and now I've met Reed, and now my life's changed. And great.
But, no, I didn't change anything?
Not yet, Ryan. Not yet.
You know what, Ryan? We're working through it.
You know how many times I've heard, you know what, Ryan?
Valentina is apologizing like crazy now.
Right, Valentina, girlfriend. Let's have some familiarity. Like, of course, everything's cool, girl. Thank you so much for your support. That's all you must know is that we really, really, really love you. And thank you.
Lindsey, are you similar to Stephanie?
Every girl is similar to a girl.
I think the question was for Lindsey, Ryan. Yeah, but she's not. You're not, are you?
Let her answer the question, Ryan.
I mean, I don't put up a BS.
Like Stephanie would.
I think you made Stephanie more like you. I think that was what was really
cool.
Lindsey literally is Stephanie. She literally is. So I guess that would mean she is like Stephanie.
I love you.
My mind is blown.
It's true. She literally is that. She literally is that character. So I would say, yeah.
Yeah, you know, it's not
blown.
True. I love you.
Is that a mind blown?
Toronto repping over here. Texas represent. Toronto and Texas, what up?
Toronto!
All right, so we'll go 5 more minutes. And so any question, last questions you guys have, send it in. Or if you want to put in a donation.
Has a question.
Cool. Who has a question?
Shout your name.
Do you have a question, Reed?
Do I have a question? I have a lot of questions.
Where's the bathroom?
Where's the bathroom at?
Who ate the last of the mayonnaise?
Yeah, what's the capital of South Dakota?
The Shmia. Yeah.
Oh, I have a question. Since it's Spirit Day, how do you guys deal with, like, I'm sure Lindsey especially, you get probably negative stuff written about you. How do you deal with that?
I smile, not at first, usually. Usually maybe there's some feelings about it at first, but then I embrace it. I embrace it because, like, okay, I'm just from a philosophy where darkness is kind of attractive. So to see how, like, mean somebody could be about you or, like, write something, I just... Somehow it reflects my own goodness back at me. Somehow, like, something inside me, like, reassures me.
What do people say?
Well, they just say that, like, I'm ugly or, like, you know,
well,
that my little skits and dances and characters that I put on aren't authentic or aren't cool or that I'm a really horrible actress. And, hey, all of that is so, like, beautifully valid because it is, and I appreciate that. It's just, like, you know, just, yeah.
Haters gonna hate.
Be at a place in yourself where, like, you can see the hurt in somebody else to lash out that way. You know, there's so many other infinite things to talk about.
I've always...
But I'm here as a lesson, no matter what. Learning and teaching, so...
I've found that whenever people say are really mean, there's usually things inside that... Usually those comments are more of a reflection of the person giving them.
Oh, it's total projection, no matter if you're ever going to attack anybody, or else you wouldn't feel the need to attack them.
Yeah, one finger pointing out, you've got 3 fingers pointing back at you.
Hey-o! Hey, Reed, have you ever had anything bad written about you, or, like, said about you?
Once somebody said I look like a Furby.
That's a compliment! Yeah. I don't think that's not bad.
Yeah, I was kind of like, after some self-reflection, I got over it.
You gotta put your head up a little or bring the camera down or something. We're just seeing your forehead.
I said, after some self-reflection, I got over it. It's kind of funny, though, like, you know, the random things people say. I don't know. It's just, if it's creative, it's pretty funny.
If it's creative, it's pretty funny, and if it's blunt and vicious, it's kind of not real, because, like, you know.
Kind of ugly.
That's just such projection.
Brian's just going to watch this now. He's
like, that's so weird. Is there a lag? Is there a slight?
No. Oh. Well, there is.
Yeah,
there's
a
slight. And also, it's just like, you know how hard it is to get up and live every day? You know? Do you know how hard it is to get up? Yes, you do, because you get up and live every day.
I do, girlfriend.
Baby, you know. So
I know.
Sometimes I just don't even get up.
Wait. No, like, let it...
Cherie wants to know, can you ask Lindsey if I could meet Gypsy or Lincoln? Who's Gypsy or Lincoln?
The dogs.
What do you mean, meet?
She's going to be in the... She's the...
Oh! Cherie! That is her name cemented in my head right now. Cherie, you're the one coming to see me.
Finish that sentence.
You're the one who is on your way out here from Nebraska, which is so cool. Of course you can meet Gypsy and Lincoln. Without a doubt, they'll be there. No problem. Without doubt. Cherie, what does Cherie mean? I'm going to look that up.
What does Cherie mean?
Yeah.
Her name?
Cherie.
Cherie, baby!
She has a crazy
life.
I can't wait to meet you, Cherie.
You're going
to
like Cherie. Cherie's awesome.
It looks like you took your top off. For a second, I'm like,
and he saw my naked boobies, and he was never the same again.
We all saw him.
It was a closed set. Nobody.
Except for the wire.
Reed.
Yeah.
Well, kind of feels like we're winding up.
Huh?
Yeah. Wait, let me just. I just want to read through these questions one last.
Okay, this will give me an opportunity to tell everybody that you know to follow us at Temps Movie, and you can. If you're not following us on Facebook yet, totally follow us on Facebook. Just search for Temps Movie on Facebook. Instagram, at Temps Movie. Especially go to the temps.com website there. Or go to search for Temps.
All know the social media sites. Go there, write Temps. It's literally T-E-M-P-S. Five letters that you have to remember, okay?
If you like movies, you'll like Temps.
Yeah. If you like interaction of any kind.
Let me just go through. Astrid Vanderhoff, it's 5:40 a.m. in Belgium. This was about an hour ago. And you stayed up all night for this hangout.
Oh, I know, wow. We talked to her.
I just wanted to let you guys and girls know that you're awesome.
Yeah, Astrid, you're the best. Oh, it's a he.
P.S. Love your acting.
Oh, it's a he.
Is it? Yeah.
Astrid?
It's so funny how genitalia changes the way we do things.
Lindsey Shaw.
Lindsey Shaw, everybody.
Lindsey, your makeup looks beautiful. That's from Sheree.
Yeah, no, it does. It really does. I was thinking that, too.
What does it read?
Yeah, you can really... It does look nice. It's like blue, isn't it?
I have blue.
It's like so blue.
Did you do your makeup both today? You did your makeup last time.
Yeah.
Did you do
I did green today just to, like, offset the perps.
It looks really good. Show off.
Of my dress.
Woo!
B-Baller 2017 says, hey, forget that. Okay. And Emmy is sending me a message. So let me read Emmy's message here.
Okay.
We'll wait.
Okay. I want to know how am I going to pass my Chinese quiz today.
Hey, you don't want to know how you're going to pass your Chinese quiz.
Well, Reed has been studying Korean.
Yep.
And
then Emily also wants to know where the name Temps came from, which... I don't know, it's an American saying, maybe it's not in your 12 languages that you know.
Yeah, temps is a temporary worker in an office.
It means temporarily valuable.
To a company.
But it's also, could be, you know, like a temp relationship.
Mm-hmm. This whole movie is kind of
valuable
about,
to a person.
Yeah, like this whole movie is kind of about, I guess, whether things last or not. It's,
or
yeah.
Whether you're valuable.
Yeah.
As a person.
This movie's not about what I just
We're
said.
We're all temps. In a way.
That's deep.
That's exactly what our movie is about. Everything we just said.
And Astrid is a girl name, by the way.
Astrid is a girl.
So thanks, Emmy Victoria.
I don't want you to go read. Like, please come over.
All right.
When are we shooting?
I'll let you know what I mean. LA.
Thank you, everyone.
I love you, Reed, with all my heart.
Bye.
Along.
Bye, Reed.
Bye,
guys.
Give the dogs kisses.
I love you.
Are you
going to Bye. Oh, my God. This is crazy right now.
You hit the button.
Oh, I think he left. He's gone. That's it.
I hit the button to leave him?
No, he did.
Leave us. It's
yeah, we have to say goodbye. But say bye in a nice way.
We love you. Thank you.
Around the world.
Nice
so long. Thank you.
All right, we'll see you next time. When's the next one?
Monday. We're going to show sex scenes.
Oh, boy.
Wait, here, you stop the broadcast.
Okay. This is my final broadcast.
Four.
How do I do it?
Three.
Oh, it's down at the bottom.
Two. One.
Psych! Not going to do it. Just kidding. Bye.